أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الحمد لله الحمد لله رب العالمين نستعينه ونستغفره ونسأله الكرامة فيما بعد الموت لنا ولجميع المؤمنين ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا وسندنا ومولانا محمدا أرسله الله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره المشركون ولذكر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد My brothers, sisters, youth, children, elderly, on this great day, أعظم الأيام عند الله, يوم النحر, day of sacrifice, I want to greet you with a greeting of Eid. تقبل الله منا ومنكم. May Allah accept of us and you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grace this occasion of Eid with blessings of happiness and faith. On this day, I want to remind you and myself that Prophet peace be upon him told us, هذا سنة أبيكم إبراهيم. This occasion is sunnah of our Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam. And اتبع ملة Ibrahim Hanifa, that Prophet peace be upon him was instructed that we follow the millet of Ibrahim Hanifa. وَمَا كَانَ مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ And he was not of those who would associate anything or anyone with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My brothers and sisters in Islam, we pray to God Almighty that God Almighty accepts our ibadat and our khairat. We pray to God Almighty that He forgives to those who have passed on from the community during the last year, and that God Almighty gives shifa and speedy recovery to those of us who are suffering. We pray to God Almighty that He saves us and all of humanity from this pandemic, so that we, inshallah, next year would be able to go for Hajj, would be able to go for Umrah, and would be fully able to visit Masajid and have our socials as God Almighty commands to us. We pray to God Almighty, that God Almighty, our Creator, Rabbuna, that He assists and helps the needy, Mazlumin, all over the world. And we pray to God Almighty that He stops Zalimin, doesn't matter who they are, that He stops violent people, doesn't matter who they are. On this great day, Yawm al-Nahr, Yawm al-Eid, my brothers and sisters in Islam, I want to remind you and myself to be conscious of Allah. I want to remind you and myself to be conscious of Allah. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ حَقَّ تُقَاتِهِ all you who believe, all you who have faith in your hearts, all you who have made a contract with God Almighty with your shahada, an agreement, be conscious of Him, your Rabb. وَلَا تَمُوتْ, as you are supposed to be, وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ, and do not allow yourself to die except in a state of Islam. I want to remind you and myself that we be obedient servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And نعبد الله, to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَعَبُدُ اللَّهَ حَتَّى يَأْتِيَكَ الْيَقِينَ, and worship God Almighty until certainty, until death approaches you, meaning hold your life. I want to remind you and myself, my brothers and sisters, to be wise Muslims, not unwise Muslims, to work hard for our actions. Iman is not about wishful thinking. Iman is about strong heart and purified action that is based on faith. ليس الإيمان بالتمني ولكن ما وقره القلب وصدقه العمل. I want to remind you all and myself on this beautiful day of Eid, the dunya is real. Dunya is real. This world, we can touch it, we can feel it, we can sense it. And oh God Almighty told us that we must use this dunya as a mazra'a tul akhirah, as a field, as a garden of the akhirah. And on the day of judgment, in the next world, فَمَنْ أُوتِيَ كِتَابَهُ بِيَمِينِهِ فَسَوْفَ يُحَاسَبُ حِسَابًا يَسِيرًا, and all of us who are given the book from the right hand, we will be tested lightly, meaning our records would be strong. I remind you and myself, my brothers and sisters, to be knowledgeable Muslims. Knowledgeable in terms of us knowing the deen and knowing the reality in which we live. Text and the context, as they say, because that's a part of our Islamic identity. I want to remind you and myself that our deen was completed as we find in a hadith that Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and companions told us that on that day the verse came, اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا. Today, on this day, on Friday, as Umar radiallahu anhu narrates, deen was completed, the end of the message, and God Almighty said in this message, ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا, and I'm happy with Islam to be your path. Won't we be happy with what God Almighty is happy? I want to remind you and myself, my brothers and sisters, that we take good care of ourselves spiritually, ethically, intellectually, physically. قد أفلح من زكاها, successful are those who purify their souls. You and I want to go to paradise? Our Prophet, peace be upon him, told us when he was asked, what is the most what takes people into paradise? He said, taqwa Allah wa husnul khuluq. Taqwa Allah wa husnul khuluq. It is consciousness of God Almighty and good manners, good behavior. Intellectually speaking, we have to do work and we have to make dua to Allah. Rabbi zidni ilma. Rabbi zidni ilma. Oh Allah, oh my Creator, increase my knowledge. Increase my knowledge. As we said many times, there is no way that we could become Muslims and remain good Muslims in a state of jahl, in a state of ignorance. And of course, we also have to take care of ourselves physically. You could see at this point of time, during COVID, if we don't take care of our health, many people have suffered. That's the reason why Prophet, peace be upon him, told us, وَعَلَى جَسَدِكَ الْحَقِّ, your body has right on you. Your body has right on you. I remind you and myself to take care of our families. Take care of your children. They are given as an amanah to you. Take care of them as the best gift that came to you into your lives. God Almighty commanded us that we have to do that. That's an order. Children, youth, all of us who do have parents, be dutiful to your parents. وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّا وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. Worship to Allah, obedience to Allah, and dutifulness to your parents. Shukr to God and shukr to your parents. Be strong in your marriages. Don't allow that current trends define how you think about marriage. Marriage is the first institution where this family is built strong. Keep relations on mawadda wa rahma, as God Almighty guided us. Appreciation and mercy. I want to remind you and myself to be part of this community, to be part of masjid. When you are part of masjid, you will not be easily moved away from your identity. You will not be easily taken away. As Prophet, peace be upon him, told us, alaykum bil jama'ah. You must be in jama'ah. فَإِنَّمَا يَأْكُلُ الدِّئْبُ الْقَاسِيَةِ. For indeed a wolf eats sheep away from its flock. If we separate from the masjid, we would lose sense of who we are. We would lose sense of identity. We must then be in continuous connection, relation with the masjid. I remind you and myself that we Muslims be united. We come from different places. We come from different regions. We come from different cultures, different linguistics, but we must work together. In the Canadian context, the only way how to survive as Muslims and good Muslims, contributing members to the Muslim community and the society, is that we are united, that we support each other, that we encourage each other. Takbir, as some scholars say, not takfir, meaning encourage each other, don't embarrass each other, don't put down each other. Unity would give us definition of our lives, my brothers and sisters. Strength. Unity would tell others that we are able to make an impact on our lives and lives of others. And we have proven when we are united, we make that impact. And lastly, I would like to remind you and myself. I would like to remind you and myself. We live in this society. This is our home. This is our Medina. With all its minuses, Canada is still the best. With all its negatives, alhamdulillah, we are all still here. And that means that, as Prophet, peace be upon him, that means that we need to love this place, take care of this place, support this place, serve this place, and definitely engage ourselves so that we can change environment of in which maybe there is a negative thinking about Muslims. From that perspective, inshallah, reminder today was about to be conscious of God. To be conscious of God. To put trust in God. لَوْ أَنَّكُمْ تَتَوَكَّلُونَ عَلَى اللَّهِ حَقَّ التَّوَكُّلِ لَرَزَقَكُمْ كِمَا يَرْزُقُ الطَّيْرِ. كِمَا يَرْزُقُ الطَّيْرِ. He would give you, that strength as and food and provisions as he gave to the bird. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين تعظيما لنبيه وتكريما لفخامة الشرف السفي. فقال عز وجل من قائل مخبرا وآمرا إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلم. الحمد لله الحمد لله الكامل والصلاة والسلام على رسولنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين تعظيما لنبيه وتكريما لفخامة شأن شرف سفيه. فقال عز وجل من قائل مخبرا وآمرا إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتوب علينا يا مولانا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عنا يا رب العالمين. Oh Allah, we ask of you to strengthen our Islamic identity as the identity of Ibrahim alayhi salam, Ismail and Hajar, ya Rabbal Alameen. Help us to strengthen the identity of our children, Ya Rabb al-Alameen, that they feel comfortable in their own skin as Muslims. We pray to you, Ya Rabb, that you make us of those who will be an example to each other, an example to the society. And we ask of you to save us and save all of human brothers and sisters from this COVID, and to stop them, doesn't matter where it is and towards whom it is directed. Ya Rabb al-Alameen. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun. Wassalamun ala al-mursaleen. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wa qul alhamdulillahi alladhi lam yattakhidh waladan wa lam yakun lahu sharikun fil mulki wa lam yakun lahu waliyyun min adh-dhulli wa kabbirhu takbira. Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar. La ilaha illallah wa Allahu akbar. Allahu akbar wa lillahi alhamd. Wa jazakumullah khaira. Please, inshallah, you may proceed outside. Gym can only go, brothers and sisters in the gym, and those inside the hall, please inshallah wait until everybody goes. Please inshallah, we are on time, alhamdulillah, we have done the service 1 minute ahead of time, so we do have time to move out. Let's go inshallah slowly. Please inshallah, don't forget SNMC, contribute to SNMC, don't forget that you need still to keep social distancing, that you still need to focus on taking care of yourself and your family, because we want you to be healthy. We want you, inshallah, for your sake, to be healthy and for the sake of others, inshallah. Please, inshallah, slowly, people from the prayer area, you can move out. Minna wa minkum, inshallah. Next Eid, inshallah, as president is saying, he's already making a decision. And that's good. Next Eid, inshallah, we'll give hugs to each other, inshallah. Jazakumullah khaira. Taqabbalallahu minna wa minkum. Please, inshallah, share my greetings with your family, sisters, to you as well. May Allah accept. Thank you very much for being part of this great community. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi.